Hey guys, I'm right here. I told Ashley the other day that I told people on Twitter the other day that I was going to be doing this live, and I had a poll for like what colors to pick for floor painting, and one person voted, and they chose vivid, so we're gonna do some vivid. Hold on, let me make sure this does not fall. Yay, there. Okay, so I have mixed up some football. Now, I'm going to do this, which you have to spread acrylic paint on first so that it has something to move across on the canvas, or in this case, some Artesia wood. And it's okay that there are other colors mixed into the white, because that will actually help it blend in there. Gives it a more cohesive look. Watch way too much Project Runway saying cohesive look. I draw this a lot. So you may notice that I have refrigerated paper, or freezer paper. This will collect the skins from the paint so that I can use them for things like jewelry or for mixed media pieces. Okay. A little bit more of this to get the edges. When you're gonna put some of these into a cut, you don't wanna put two colors that are too close in, like the color scheme to each other. So like, you don't wanna put a purple next to a purple. You also don't wanna put a purple next to a blue or a pink or a red. So instead, we're gonna use some of this green. Then, I'm going to use some of this artist line silver. I know this is gonna end up being like turned the wrong way, and I'm sorry. My tripod is kind of annoying. Oh wait, there. That'll work. I'm gonna put some of this metallic down here. Some pretty mixed white. My El Cheapo palette knife. And I'll let it sit there for a minute. And we'll go to the next. How many of these would you have done in a relatively short period of time? Mixing some metallic blue. Thank you.
hardest lock metallic cobalt is like gorgeous. Every time. Okay. So let's pick some of this. Just from a hot craft store that shall be nameless. Because we no longer shop there. It's some sort of blue. Some shade of blue. And it didn't close properly. It's hard to get out. And then I'm going to add in some regular white acrylic. Again, you don't have to primer the palette knife too much to do this. Because it's all gonna blend together. Seriously, I like to tune down for cohesive look. And how are you feeling, even though Christian Siriano and Carly Foss get out? I teach them on every other Saturday, so if you want to try that, you can. And I will, we do our sign-ups for our Flower Week on Eventbrite, so you can sign up for classes with me or any other art teacher on me. Just look for Huntsville Art Week. Get some. up in that other direction. You feel urged to move it. So that you will see that lovely blank canvas. Thank you. like with a wet on wet technique in watercolor. It gives it the, it gives the paint something to actually fill on top of instead of dry canvas. So just to cover the whole thing. Just imagine I've done this for a canvas that is actually twice as long as this one. One and two thirds times the Now you're probably thinking that was like a big, huge mess. And it is, but it's going to be a beautiful mess too. It is going to be the prettiest mess. Anyway, besides my hands. So. I connected that water to that copper. You may notice that I don't use silica, which is unusual apparently, but it causes some archival issues with paint, so I find it to be a bad idea. But if other people use it, they can. I just don't want to. It's just a personal preference. If you want to use it, you can. I won't judge too much. See? As you add more paint, so you want to make sure that it drips off any excess. So now let's go to our final two pieces of the day. Let's see. How will I set this up? I think I'm just back to doing dirty dishes. So let's put some deco art gray, which probably doesn't sound very vibrant. Gave a
first place. I'm Violet. enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time.